With the release of iPhone 14 and 14 Pro, many expected Apple to drop the 10-year-old Lightning port in favor of USB-C, but that didn't happen. And with the European Commission requiring smartphones to adopt USB-C by 2024, it's made the iPhone's transition away from Lightning appear inevitable. So why is Apple taking so long to do it? Well, their official answer is for user convenience. This may sound counterintuitive since it would be more convenient if all modern electronics used the same port, but Apple argues that for the last decade, iPhone customers have been accumulating various Lightning cables, adapters, and accessories that would be rendered useless if iPhones switched to USB-C. And there is some truth to this, since in 2012, the transition away from the 30-pin connector to Lightning caused substantial outrage among iPhone users, who claimed Apple was being greedy by forcing customers to not only buy a new iPhone, but also buy all new cables and accessories. But could there be something more to Apple's reluctance to adopt USB-C on iPhone? Well, I think there is. Apple tends to be very aggressive with transitions to new standards. They were one of the first to switch from floppy disks to CD drives on iMac, the first to ditch their own FireWire standard on MacBook, and one of the first to remove USB-A entirely from their notebooks. And considering the iPad already ditched Lightning 4 years ago, why is Apple so insistent on keeping Lightning on iPhone? I suspect the answer is money. Apple actually takes a cut on every Lightning accessory sold by third parties thanks to their MFi program, which requires companies to pay a licensing fee to use Apple's Lightning connector in their products. But this isn't a one-time payment. Instead, it's a small fee paid for every unit sold, forever. No one knows the exact amount, but many speculate the fee is between $2 to $4, potentially generating hundreds of millions of dollars a year for Apple, which makes their hesitation to move away from Lightning more understandable, since they'd instantly be losing a $100 million business. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.